So my dear beloved brothers and sisters, we are at that moment now where we have the privilege and the good fortune to welcome our feature speaker for this evening, and he is Mufti Farid Jamal Moini. It was not too long ago that I remember, even before he went to pursue his further studies, that he was serving as the imam at the Bronte Village Masjid, or at least assisting in that capacity. And from there he went on to study in South Africa at the very prestigious Darul Uloom Gharib Nawaz, and after that he pursued his Islamic studies even further, attaining the qualification of Mufti. He's currently serving as the assistant imam at the Makoon Street Asja Jamaat. He will be speaking to us this evening about Ta'zim of the Blessed Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So it is our great pleasure to invite to address us this evening Mufti Farid Jamal Moini.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, khaliqis samawati wal ardeen, thumma salatu wa salamu ala man kana nabiyan wa arimul bayna al-ma'i wa teen. Ajmalil ajmalil, akmalil akmalil, Sayyiduna Nabiyuna Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, wa alihi wa ashabihi wa ali baytihi ajma'in. وبعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وَأَصْحَابِ سَيِّدِنَا وَمَوْلَانَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَبَارِكَ وَسَلِّمَ صَلَاةٌ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَيْكَ يَا سَيِّدِي يَا طَبِيبِي يَا حَبِيبِي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ Collectively, with loud voices, let us send durood and salams to our holy prophet Sayyiduna Nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وأصحاب سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم صلاة وسلام عليك يا سيدي يا طبيبي يا حبيبي يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear distinguished ulama ikram, scholars of Islam, highly respectable, and our beloved teacher, Hazrat Allama Maulana Siddiq Ahmed Nasir, brothers and sisters, Aima Imams, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Alhamdulillah, we praise Allah Almighty that we are here for Mawlid al-Nabi, subhanallah. Alhamdulillah, we praise Allah Almighty that we are Muslims. Alhamdulillah, we praise Allah Almighty that we are chosen amongst His special servants to celebrate and rejoice in His bounties and mercies. Subhanallah. And this is something that is chosen. Not everyone is afforded this opportunity. Yes. Not everyone is afforded the opportunity to rejoice in the mercy and bounties of Allah Almighty. Tonight, inshallah, me khoshish karunga, I will try to speak a little bit about Ta'zim al-Nabi, inshallah. Especially, I want you to listen nicely, inshallah, and take notes. I want to speak about the issue that we are faced with. Because for the last couple of weeks, especially in this month, many questions are coming as to why we stand for Ta'zim. This is shirk. This is this, this is that. The one who celebrates Mawlid al-Nabawi, the one who stands for Ta'zim, Salah behind that person is not accepted. Na'udhu billah. These are the statements that the young people are concerned about, and they come and they ask us for jawab, for a response. So inshallah, Allah Almighty mentions in the Holy Quran in chapter 10, verse 58, قُلْ بِفَدْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَهُ هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Say, in the bounty of Allah Almighty and in His mercy, let them rejoice. Brothers and sisters, know that Shaitan, Iblis, he cried 4 times. How many? 4 times. And he's crying even today. And in this month, he's even crying more. SubhanAllah. I mean, he cried until Qiyamah and after Qiyamah. He cried 4 times. First, when Allah Almighty declared him as curse, Ar-Rajim. And secondly, when he was thrown out. And third, when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was born. SubhanAllah. And fourth, when Surah Fatiha was revealed. Fourth, when Surah Fatiha was revealed. And in these programs, we make Fatiha, we make dua. And there are people who are crying about the Mawlid and Nabawi, crying about Tazim and Nabawi, and crying about the Fatiha. May they join their imams. O Muslims, brothers and sisters, a Muslim's response to the birth of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to rejoice in the bounties and mercy of Allah. I will not go into depth with this, but it's a point I want you to think. I need to build your minds to the point that I want to register. Take you from the unknown to the known, inshallah. A Muslim's rejoice in the birth of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to rejoice in the bounties and mercies of Allah Almighty. Allah Almighty mentions in the Holy Quran, قُلْ بِفَدْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِي فَبِذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَهُ. And San Fernando, Jama'ah, Masjid, they are rejoicing in the mercy and bounty of Allah Almighty. They are following the sunnah of Sahaba Ikram. Yes, you are following the sunnah of Sahaba Ikram by gathering in the masjid, and thanking Allah for granting you the favor of Islam and for sending us Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I will give dalil of this, inshallah. But firstly, just to touch on it, what the ulama Ikram said about this verse, chapter 10, verse 58, the bounty and mercy of Allah. Some people say that the bounty and mercy of Allah is not Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But they are incorrect. And they follow another school of thought. They are not amongst the Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. O Muslims, brothers and sisters, tafsir of the Quran with the Quran. Firstly, the Quran explains other verses of the Quran. Allah Almighty clearly emphasized and has made clear that the mercy of Allah Almighty is His Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have not sent you, but as a mercy to all the worlds. SubhanAllah, Surah Al-Anbiya. Hence, without a shadow of doubt, the arrival of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a mercy not only upon us, but رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, to all the worlds, all the creations of Allah Almighty, mankind and jinns. Ibn al-Jawzi explains, قُلْ بِفَدْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِي فَبِذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَهُ إِلَى الْآخِرِ. Ayat, chapter 10, verse 58, Ibn Jawzi, what he says that, narrated by Ad-Dahaq and from Ibn Abbas, radiyallahu anhuma, that the bounty mentioned in this verse means knowledge, ilm. It means ilm. The fadl of Allah Almighty means ilm. And if you have ilm, you will be on Sirat al-Mustaqim. And if you don't have ilm, you will not be on Sirat al-Mustaqim. You'll be between. So he says that this bounty means the ilm, the Quran and Tawheed. Whereas the rahmah means Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Azad al-Masir fi Tafsir by Ibn Jawzi, volume 4, page 40. Moving on, just quoting the ulama, the scholars. Imam Abu Hayyan al-Andalusi, great scholar of Islam in Tafsir Bahr al-Muhit. These are the books that the ulama read, the scholars. And we get terrified to just misquote You know, in Bahr al-Muhit, volume 5, page 171, he mentions that the bounty refers to the knowledge, whereas the mercy refers to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Jalaluddin As-Suyuti, alayhi rahma, he mentioned in Darul Manthur, volume 4, page 330, Abu Shaykh narrated from Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with them both, that the bounty of Allah means knowledge, whereas the mercy means Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we can go on. Allama Alusi alayhi rahmah. He mentions that Al-Khatib and Ibn Asakir, that the bounty refers to An-Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ru'ul Ma'ani. And Mawlana Sahib is mawjood. And Shaykh is mawjood. These are authentic ulama of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. So the bounty and mercy means Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, is there any further evidence on rejoicing in the bounty of Allah means rejoicing in the birth of Prophet Muhammad? And I want you to listen carefully. Chapter 62, verse 4. ذَلِكَ فَدْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَدْلِ الْعَظِيمِ Subhanallah. That is the bounty of Allah. ذَلِكَ فَدْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ The bounty of Allah whom He bestows to whomever He wishes. Subhanallah. That is the bounty of Allah which He has given unto whom He will. And Allah is infinite in bounty. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَدْلِ الْعَظِيمِ So Allah is infinite in bounty and He's bestowing Islam and prophethood upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it's also bestowing upon us Islam. He has sent the believers, sent to the believers, and Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا هُوَ الَّذِي بَعَثَ فِي الْأُمِّيِّينَ رَسُولًا مِنْهُمْ And this verse I want you to pay special attention to. Chapter 62, verse 3. وَآخِرِينَ مِنْهُمْ لَمَّا يَلْحَقُوا بِهِمْ And He has sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to others amongst them who have not yet joined them but will come. Tawajjuh, ulama ikram. Wa akhirin minhum lamma yalhaqu bihim. And the akhirin, the believers who never saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who are not among sahaba ikram, ta'abin, ta'aba ta'abin. It is referring to us, the believers in the end of time and coming along afterwards. In chapter 62, verse 3. So this verse refers to those generations of believers who did not see the Prophet ﷺ physically. But they are excluded. They are not excluded from the mercy and blessings of Rasulullah ﷺ. He's a mercy and blessing for us. So some people may say, this fadl and bounty was only when Rasulullah ﷺ was alive. But the tafsir of the Quran explains that no, this is for wal akhirin minhum and those who come afterwards, later on, generations. He is a mercy and bounty for them. An important note, O Muslims, brothers and sisters. Allah is mentioning that He is Zul Fadlil Azim, the owner of grace. And He, Allah Almighty, this ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ This fadl, this ilm, this knowledge and this mercy And the rahmah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is given to whomever he wills. And he is the owner and possessor of this. So there are some people who do not receive this guidance. And it is clear who such people are. People who don't accept La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. So be thankful for this. And be thankful moreover that you are able to practice a sunnah. Is sunnah of Sahaba Ikram. What do I say? I will inform you of this hadith. Very important. Because I know you don't need these dalil, but your mind is being questioned and you are being tampered and pestered. You know, they're after you. Hey, why are you doing this celebration, this mawlid? It's not amongst the sunnah, it's not amongst Sahaba Ikram. Oh, Muslims, brothers and sisters, open your book, Sahih Muslim, Sunnah an Nasa'i. Sahih Muslim in the Arabic translation, in the Arabic book is hadith number 2701. In the English book is Hadith number 6521. In Riyadu Salihin, Hadith number 1450. Mishkatul Masabi, Hadith number 2278. And in the English translation of Sunnah an Nasa'i, it is Hadith 5428. What is this hadith that I'm about to mention? And the reason for telling you this. Hazrat Muawiyah, may Allah be pleased with him, said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went out to a circle. He went out to a halaqa, a circle, a gathering of his companions, and said, what are you doing? They said, we have come together to pray to Allah and praise Him for guiding us to His religion. Subhanallah. Are you here to praise Allah and thank Him for guiding us to Islam? Alhamdulillah. It's not finished. And for blessing us with you, O Muhammad. For blessing us with you, O Muhammad. He said, I ask you, by Allah, is that the only reason that you are coming together? O people of San Fernando Jama'a Masjid, O invitees on behalf of the Imam and the Masjid, is there any other reasons you are coming here tonight? I don't think so. I don't think we are going to drink coffee and make some business deals. I don't think someone is going to sell a vehicle. There's no other reason but what? To thank Allah for the favor of granting us Islam and sending us Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I'm not asking you to swear to an oath because of any suspicion. I don't think that you are gathering for any other reason. But the reason why I'm asking, rather, Sayyiduna Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salam came to me and he told me that Allah Almighty, and listen, Allah Almighty, subhanallah, I feel better if I read the Arabic. وَإِنَّمَا آتِي جِبْرِيلُ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ فَأَخْبَرْنِي أَنَّ اللَّهَ أَزَّ وَجَلْ يُبَاهِي بِكُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ Subhanallah, subhanallah. That Allah Almighty, He is rejoicing to His angels, subhanallah, and boasting of you. O Muslims, Sahaba Ikram came together for what? To thank Allah, Ya Allah, we make shukr to you for granting us Islam, the Hidayah, that many people don't have. Oh Allah, we thank you for sending us Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is this not enough evidence? And yet still when it is presented, they reject. So this mercy and this bounty of Allah Almighty, the fadl, the ilm, and the mercy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's not inclusive to everyone. This ilm, not everyone possesses this knowledge. Stick to the ulama of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Hold on to the daman of Hazrat Allama, Hazrat Mawlana Siddiq Ahmed Nasir. Keep firm to Mawlana Atif Sulaimani. And all the other scholars of Islam, follow them. They will guide you. O Muslims, brothers and sisters, with regards to ta'zim, and I will not be too long. Allah Almighty mentions in the Holy Quran, Inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nazira litu'minu billahi wa rasulihi wa tu'azziruhu wa tuwakkiruhu wa tusabbihuhu bukratan wa asila. O Messenger of Allah, verily we have sent you as a witness, right? A bringer of glad tidings and a warner of punishment, so that people may believe in Allah and His Messenger, and that you, O believers, you may revere Him and respect Him. وَتُعَزِّرُهُ وَتُوَقِّرُهُ You may revere and respect Him, and that you sanctify your Lord in the morning and evening. O Muslims, notice in this verse, chapter 48, verses 8 and 9, the reason for which this religion was given and the Quran was revealed, there are three reasons. As mentioned in this verse, that people may bear faith in Allah and His Messenger. لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ They may bear faith, تُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ Believe in Allah and His Messenger. And after this, very important, وَتُعَزِّرُهُ وَتُوَكِّرُهُ Then, wow, harfi atf. وَتُسَبِّهُ بُكْرَةً وَعَسِيلًا وَتُسَبِّحُهُ بُكْرَةً وَعَسِيلًا And then you worship Allah morning and evening. Then you establish Salah. First is Iman. In between is what? Reverence and respect to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then it is Salah. Your Quran. لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُعَزِّرُهُ وَتُوَقِّرُهُ وَتُسَبِّحُهُ بُكْرَةً وَعَسِيلًا قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْمَجِيدِ. So after being faith and iman in Allah Almighty and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we should learn how to respect Him, how to revere Him, and then Salah comes into place. A salah without respect and reverence to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is not the perfect salah. Oh Muslims, brothers and sisters, in our present time, some people, due to their misunderstanding, consider the immense love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam equivalent to shirk. In spite of the fact that the lovers of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam consider Rasulullah, we consider him to be Abdullah. He's a slave, a bondsman of Allah, nothing much. We do not attribute anything of divinity to him. We do not attribute this. And we will not attribute this. And we have no intentions of comparing the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to Allah Almighty Azza wa Jal. Na'auzu billah, we are free from this. Now the comparison only comes due to the ill thinking of opponents who took certain ways, or they look for ways, just to accuse Muslims of shirk and kufr, to separate the Muslims. But they forget to say that this is false takfir. By declaring others disbeliever, this is takfir. And it will be turned towards them. They say, and I quote, those who stand for the ta'zim and sing it, they say that they do so on an account of their love and respect for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This, however, is not acceptable, since this practice has not been established in the teachings of Islam. This is a grave error which they must correct, since their understanding is opposing to the teachings of Islam. According to the majority of scholars, it will be makruh, reprehensible, to perform salah behind one who is involved in these practices. And one should avoid this, end of quote. Tonight, inshallah, and no one is taking notes. I hope someone is taking notes. The video may be lost. I will shed light on this, inshallah. Some people disagree with ta'zim, standing and sending salams on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now, standing and sending salams on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is proven from the Quran and Sunnah. It's proven from the Quran and Sunnah. Alhamdulillah, Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they are blessed with this fadl, this ilm, and the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Yes, it is an act proven from the Quran and Sunnah, and it is not shirk. Do not be worried. To stand and greet a prophet with the words, Ya Nabi Salam Alaika, peace be upon you, O Prophet. The Holy Prophet himself, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, did this, and the companions also did this. When the Muslims stand and they recite the ta'zim, what is it that they are reciting? When we are going to have ta'zim, what are we reciting? They sing, Ya Nabi Salam Alaika, Ya Rasul Salam Alaika, Ya Habib Salam Alaika. This statement of Ya Nabi Salam Alaika is accepted in Salah. This statement of Ya Nabi Salam Alaika is accepted in Salah, in our 5 daily Salah. While praying to Allah Almighty under the statement of Ya Nabi Salam Alaika, and this is accepted, subhanallah. Why would a sane intellectual person reject this statement of Ya Nabi Salam Alaika outside of Salah? When a Muslim is closest to his Lord Allah Almighty in Salah, worshipping his Lord, turning to him, Allah Almighty, turning towards the Kaaba and uttering the statement, Ya Nabi Salam Alaika, in his Salah, is accepted and not rejected, nor is it termed kufr, disbelief. Now someone may ask, where in Salah is Ya Nabi Salam Alaika recited? In Tashahud, Atahiyatu Lillahi wa Salawatu wa Tayyibatu, Assalamu Alaika Ayyuhan Nabiyyu wa Rahmatullahi wa Barakatuhu. Now, pay special attention. As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi salihin. Ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasul. And understand the translation. All compliments, prayers, and pure words are due to Allah. Peace be upon you, O Prophet, and the mercy of Allah and His blessings. Peace be upon us and upon the righteous slaves of Allah. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His slave and messenger. This is found in Sahih Bukhari. So every day in our salah, 5 times a day, we are saying, Ya Nabi Salam Alaika. As-salamu alayka ya ayyuhan nabi is translated as ya nabi salam alayka. It's the same in Arabic. It's just turned around. And the ulama are here. It's the same statements. Now, one may say, but this is in tashahud, in tahiyyat. How is this in salah? Come to the point, Mufti Sahab. You're wasting our time. We need to get to the point. Now, coming to the point, alhamdulillah, I want you to understand this ruling. This is an important ruling, right? On the statement of As-salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi, peace be upon you, O Prophet of Allah, is the same as Ya Nabi Salam alayka. Now reciting the tashahud is necessary. It is wajib. Both in the first sitting and after the 2 rakats, if there is a 4 rakat cycle. And in the final sitting at the end of the prayer, but not obligatory, it's not fard. Omitting it doesn't invalidate the prayer, but does make the prayer deficient. When in necessary, a wajib action is left forgetfully, forgetfulness, prostrations are necessary. But when it's not done, when it's a necessary action, the wajibat are left deliberately, it's not necessary. This is a ruling. Now, important point, the things that invalidate the prayer are well known. For example, the same things that break the wudu. All right? Such that, you know, we pass wind, etc. Now, deliberately omitting a wajibat of the prayer, such as in the first tashahud. But if a person forgets his prayer, it is valid. It forgets it, not intentionally, but forgets it. The prayer is valid. Now, what about in salah, if we were, for example, send salams to someone while standing, like Brother Ashton is standing, and I would come in the masjid and he's alone, and I would give salams. Assalamu alaikum. And Ashton would reply, Wa alaikum assalam. Wa assalamu alaikum, ya Farid. Salah is broken. The salah is broken. Now, the point that I want you to bear in mind here and understand, in salah, certain actions that we do can cause our salah not to be valid, can break our salah. For example, sending salams and greetings to anyone. Your namaz is fasid. Now, however, during salah, if we were to send salams on a Nabi, any Nabi, be in particular, for example, Nabi Nuh alayhi salam, Prophet Moses, Prophet Isa, Elias, Elijah, and any other prophet, Abraham alayhi salam, our salah is valid. Look at the honor Allah Almighty has placed in salah. You can send salams to a Nabi. Now I'll be more explicit and clear. O Muslims, brothers and sisters, for example, and I want you to contemplate on this verse. In salah, after Surah Fatiha, minimum we recite 3 ayats of the Quran. 3 ayats of the Quran, right? That's the minimum, according to the Anaf. So if, for example, we would say, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِهِ الَّذِينَ اسْتَفَىٰ, and peace be upon the servants whom He, Allah Almighty, has chosen. If you are in Salah after Surah Fatiha, you recite this ayah, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِهِ الَّذِينَ اسْتَفَىٰ, and peace be upon the chosen servants of Allah. Who are the chosen servants of Allah? Awliya ikram, the saints, the prophets. So in salah, you can send specifically to an individual salams. And what is the position? You are standing and your hands are folding. And your salah is accepted. Now to make even more clear and be particular, Allah says, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ اسْتَفَىٰ, the chosen servants. The Quran is full of wisdom and knowledge. In chapter 19, verse 5, Allah Almighty says, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَيْهِ يَوْمَ وُلِدَ وَيَوْمَ يَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ يُبْعَثُ حَيَّا. And salams be upon John, on Yahya, the day he was born and the day when he dies and the day he will be risen alive. And you are standing like this. And you are reciting these verses of the Quran. Salams be upon you, O Yahya, John the Baptist. Oh, let us be more clear. وَسَلَامُ عَلَى مَنِ اتَّبَعَ الْهُدَىٰ. And peace be upon those who follow guidance. Chapter 20, verse 42. In Salah, you are standing, right? Understand? And you are standing. Peace be upon those who are given chosen guidance. Oh Muslims, your Quran is full of ilm. Let us be more clear. Particular coming to a Nabi now. And after Surah Fatiha, we include in our recitation of Qiraat, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ نُوفِ الْعَالَمِينَ. And you are standing, and according to the Anaf, folding your hands, and it is below the navel. If you are another school of thought, it is at the side. But you are standing, and you are in Qiyam, and you are saying, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ نُوفِ الْعَالَمِينَ. And salam be upon Noah throughout the world. Is there any mufti that can issue a fatwa that it is shirk? There is no mufti today or until Qiyamah, none will come, that they can issue a fatwa that this is shirk. Because this is your Quran, this is your Islam. Oh Muslims, I'm coming to the point. And if we say, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمُ, ayat of the Quran, in your salah, you are sending salams directly to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. Your salah is valid. If we say, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ مُوسَىٰ وَحَارُونَ, salah to valid in the Mufti Sahib, Mawlana Sahib. And we say, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ إِلْيَاسِينَ. So now, the question will say, but Mufti Saab, you have not come to the point. Where does it prove sending salams to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? These are all different Nabi. Allah Almighty has removed the ambiguity and made it clear when he says, Subhana Rabbika Rabbil Izzati Amma Yasifoon Wasalamun Alal Mursaleen وَالْحَمْدُلِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So all ambiguity is removed. It is clear. And peace be upon all messengers. So for one to reject sending salams in the position of standing and folding the hands like this, then it means they do not accept Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a messenger. It means that they do not accept him to be amongst the Salihin. It means they do not accept him to be amongst those who are given guidance. Because the Quran, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ إِبَادِ الَّذِينَ اسْتَفَاهُ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ الْهُدَىٰ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. O Muslims, brothers and sisters, and coming to an end, when we look for those who go to Hajj and Umrah, Fatwa al-Hindiyah, Dusunam Fatwa Al-Mghiri. And the other name is Fatwa Al-Mghiri. Volume 1, page 265 in the Arabic book. For those who Allah grants to go for Hajj and Umrah, inshallah, may He accept all of us to go for Hajj and Umrah, inshallah. Work hard for it, inshallah. We should act upon it and we should stand. The sunnah of making ziyarat of the Qabr in Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is standing with folded arms. And it is done in Salah, as it is done in Salah whilst visiting the grave of the Prophet, as is mentioned in Fatwa al-Hindiyah, Kitab al-Manasik, The Etiquette of Ziyarat al-Nabi, Volume 1, page 265. The sunnah is for us to stand and fold our hands just as how we do in namaz. Al-Mghiri says, stand before the blessed Rawda Sharif, the tomb of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as you stand in Salah, with the feeling in mind that the Holy Prophet is resting in his blessed grave, and he knows and he listens to the person standing before him, and he says, As-salamu alayka ya Nabi Allah wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, ashadu annaka Rasulullah. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. And in closing, I would like to share with you this point. This is a very important point. You see, we need to accept the sunnah completely of our Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, not pick and choose. What I'm about to say, I might face criticism for, but nonetheless, it is about highlighting and educating. Sheikh Atiya Sakhr, the former head mufti of Al-Azhar, he issues a fatwa. And this is important for the Muslims to understand. Because people say, standing for the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is not proven from the Sahaba. This is not true. This is an untruth. Today you'll understand Sahaba stood for him out of respect. This is not true. This is misconstrued points and misguidance. The Sheikh mentions, at which time should the people stand for prayer, for Iqamah, when they hear Iqamah, the final call for prayer. Maulana Atif Tujante, kis nukta. You understand why I'm mentioning this point? Because over here, the practice is different. But the practice of the Hanafi school of thought, throughout the Muslim world, where they are Sunnis, they sit for the Iqamah. Only the Muazzin stands. And at a certain time, at Hayyal al-Salah, Hayyal al-Salah, come for Salah. This is the time you stand. This is according to Hanaf. We are Hanafis. This is according to the Hanaf. To do otherwise is a khilaf of the Hanaf. But some ulama mentions you may stand at the Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. But why is this such? And why is this mentioned, a whole chapter in Sahih Bukhari, at the time of standing for Iqamah? The Sahaba Ikram stood. The Iqamah was for reverence to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Takbir Tahrima was for Allah Almighty. Oh Muslims, this Sheikh, he mentions, the head of Azhar University, mentions in the commentary of Muslim, Sahih Muslim, Imam Nawawi states that the Muslim scholars amongst both Salaf, the righteous predecessors, and the Khalaf, yani their successors, those who come after, hold different views regarding the time or point at which people should stand for the prayer. The opinion of Imam Shafi and other scholars is that it is recommended that people should stand until the Muazzin finishes the Iqamah, the Shafi school of thought. When the Muazzin finishes the Iqamah, then the people should stand and make the saf for Salah. The opinion of Imam Shafi is such. Other scholars is that it is recommendable that people should not stand until the Muazzin finishes the Iqamah. Qari Iyad said to have reported from Imam Malik and the majority of the scholars of the Maliki school of thought that it is desirable to stand when the Muazzin starts giving the Iqamah. When the Muazzin starts giving the Iqamah. This is from the Maliki school of thought. Hazrat Anas used to stand when he heard the formula, Qad Qamati Salah. Hazrat Anas, Sahaba Ikram used to stand when he heard Qad Qamati Salah. And I want you to listen attentively. This is a very important point. Alright? Then this is the opinion by Imam Ahmad as well. Imam Abu Hanifa and the people of Kufa used to stand in the row for prayer when the Muazzin says, or when the Muazzin said, Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala salah. Now, based on this, O people, Muslims can stand as soon as the Iqamah starts when they hear either the formula Hayya ala salah or Qad Qamati salah, which is totally opposite to what we do. Right? It's totally opposite to what we do. Now, and I will close because I realize I'm going beyond my time and some people are getting a bit nervous. I will close now. But this point, I want you to understand this, O Muslims. Why we stand for Iqamah? Sahaba Ikram stood for Iqamah for the reverence and love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Iqamah is for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is Iqamah. This standing is called standing of ta'zim, respect for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I mentioned just one hadith and come to an end. In this, it's mentioned that when the Sahaba Ikram would stand for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hazrat Bilal, he would wait for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to come out from his blessed room. And only when he exited his room, then would Bilal start, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Then he would start the Iqamah. And then the companions would know that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came out. But we must understand from this hadith that I'm about to mention, كَانَ بِلَالٌ يُعَذِّنُ إِذَا دَحَدَتْ فَلَا يُقِيمُ حتى يخرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فإذا خرج أقام الصلاة حين يراه. Bilal used to make the call for prayer and he would not recite the Iqama until the Prophet came out. When he came out, Bilal would recite the Iqama when he saw him. This is from Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim on the chapter when to stand for Iqama. Sayyidina Bilal will not go to call the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for prayer. The purpose for Iqama was to inform the companions that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had exited his blessed room and to stand up for veneration for him. And this is called the standing for ta'zim or istiqbal. The ulama ikram, they understand this. Now, in mentioning this, they used to say, إِذَا أُقِيمَتِ الصَّلَاةَ فَلَا تَقُومُ حَتَّى تَرَانِي. When the Iqama is recited, do not stand until you see me. When the Iqama is recited, do not stand until you see me. Now, Rasulullah ﷺ mentioned, do not stand until you see me. إِذَا أُقِيمَتِ الصَّلَاةَ فَلَا تَقُومُ حَتَّى تَرَانِي عَلَيْكُمْ بِالسَّقِينَةِ. When the Iqama is recited, do not stand until you see me. Calmness is obligated on you. Do not behave hastily. حَتَّى تَرَانِي قَدْ خَرَجْتَ. When I come out. Now, Hazrat Abu Huraira narrates, and I will end with this now. Our ulama will understand and appreciate this. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ تُقَامُ لِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Surely the iqama, the qayim, the qiyam of the ritual prayer used to be held for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. O Muslims, brothers and sisters, time does not permit. I've come to an end of tonight's presentation. Standing for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it is part of the sunnah of sahaba ikram. In salah, when you make the saf and you're standing, you should sit. You stand at Hayya al-Salah, Hayya al-Falah, Qad Qamati Salah, we are Anaf. And we practice this in the Sunni places in the world that you travel. Sunni ulama, they came, they saw everyone standing for prayer. They said, Maulana Sahib, you're not educating your people. I said, why? He said, we are Sunnis. Teach the people, according to the Anaf at least. The Anaf says you stand at Hayya al-Salah. Why? Because this is out of respect for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sahaba Ikram did this every day, 5 times a day. So for those who refute and they say that we should not that standing for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not part of the sunnah, they have not read this chapter in Sahih Bukhari. Because your basis of iqamah, the iqamah is for Rasulullah venerating him. And the takbir is for Allah. May Allah Almighty, if you need further clarification, just contact me, we will discuss this. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.